Greetings and praise the Lord, everyone. My name is Lady Brenda Henley. I am International Women Council Vice President of Home Mission. It gives me great pleasure to be here today with a woman of God who's full of the word, and I can say she is a friend of mine. But before we get started, let us have a word of prayer. Lord, Heavenly Father, we come before you asking your blessings to be upon us. First of all, we do want to just thank you for allowing us to come together today. We thank you for this great organization of women, the International Women Council, and all of the past presidents, all the workers, all the women of God. And Lord, as we move forward, bless us today as we go through this interview celebrating the month of March of women. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
So we're here with this beautiful woman of God, and I have so much I could say about her, but one thing I admire about her, I know that she's full of the word of God. She has a flair for creativity that can be seen whether she's planning activities for a church, for her community, for her nonprofit programs, and even for the IWC. She served as president number 11 of the International Women Council. Please help me welcome today, Lady Melody Christian. Praise the Lord, Melody Christian.
Praise the Lord. Praise Him.
Praise Him. So good to see you. So good to have you with us today. And just we just thank God for you. And as we start to open up, just asking you a few questions. I remember you as being quite a songbird, love to sing beautiful songs. What is your favorite song and why is it your favorite?
That's really kind of hard. My favorite song, well, mm-hmm. It's hard to pinpoint one, just one.
But I'm
I would
sure.
say The Name of Jesus Is So Sweet.
Yes.
Great is thy faithfulness. And Fill My Cup, Lord. Love that. Love that song. Yeah. So I would say those are on the top of my favorites. But I'm a hymn person. Contemporary is fine. I enjoy that as well. But my go-to will always be a hymn.
Amen. 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 And there's so much in him. So we thank God for that. I also want to ask you, now, if I remember correctly, you grew up in Brooklyn under the leadership of Apostle Wilbur Jones at Beulah Church on Marcy Avenue in Brooklyn. And I know he is a man that's full of the word. So I know there's many scriptures that he taught. And I'm just wondering, what is your favorite scripture and what does it mean to you?
Yes, I did grow up under Apostle Wilbur Jones. We started at Refuge Temple, and mm-hmm. when he was appointed to be pastor in Brooklyn, then we also went to Brooklyn with him, mm-hmm. and he kept us in the word. He was really strict with the young people. We had all night prayer and we could not actually go to sleep. We really had to be praying, singing, and reading the words. So my favorite scripture is, I would tell you to guess because it's real obvious, but it is Philippians 4:13.
Yes,
I can do all things through Christ,
which
strengthens me.
Yeah,
it has always been my favorite scripture.
Yes.
And I don't know if it was because I grew up in a woman's council and that was the motto. I don't know. But as I, became an adult, it stuck with me. I got the full meaning of it. And it's always better to rely on his strength than my own strength.
Amen.
And when I am weak, I'm yet made strong.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
So it's Philippians 4:13.
Amen. I kind of figured that. And same here, because it's a scripture that gets you through when you think you can't go any further. That's good to remind you that you can, that you can.
Yes.
Praise
Amen.
That. Now, I know that you married and you have two children. How did your personal life, and this is a two-part question, how did your personal life change as a result of becoming president? And what was your initial thought when you learned you were the IWC president? How'd that make you feel?
Well, how did it change my personal life as being a result of being president? Well, I don't travel as much. Mm-hmm. I do miss traveling. Mm-hmm. It was a joy to visit the Saints on their mm-hmm. home turf, as opposed mm-hmm. to seeing everyone at conventions. It was nice to be on their home turf. You got to learn yeah. them, get to know them a little bit on an intimate basis. In reference to my work, I grew up in a big church. I've been a servant leader since I was young. So being president didn't change my life and that aspect that much. I just continued to do what I mm-hmm. had been doing for years, but just on a larger level. Mm-hmm. And how did I feel when I became president? Wow, it was so many emotions running through me at that particular time. Shocked, mm-hmm. that would be a good word, and grateful, okay. honored. Amen. You know, I was like, wow, they chose me. Mm-hmm. Back in the day, we didn't have elections and everybody was appointed. So to be elected by the people really felt good. I felt honored and humbled.
Amen. Amen. Can you still hear me okay?
Yes, I hear you fine.
Okay. Thank God. I'm sorry. Okay, my next question to you was, what was your theme when you were president of the IWC?
Wow, now this is what, 2021, and we talk about 2013. Well, I left the original theme and the motto intact. Mm-hmm. Unity is our theme, glory is our goal.
Yes.
And the motto being, of course, Philippians 4:13. And what I did was I used a statement of purpose each year. The first 2 years it stayed the same. That's the purpose was, we unify to glorify God in the spirit of excellence. And it was taken from Daniel 6:3.
Yes.
And 2014, it was still here, still standing, still mm-hmm. strong. And that was taken from Philippians 4:13.
4:13, yes, yes, yes. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I remember that. I remember powerful themes that led the women of God. So I guess my next question would be, what are some of the accomplishments from your administration for which you are most proud?
Let's see. I'm proud of the executive staff handbooks. Mm-hmm. For years, we didn't have a lot of detail about what each person's job description was. So creating those handbooks for each executive staff members so they would know exactly what to do, what was expected of them, and basically how to get it done and just to add their gifts to that. That was an accomplishment that I was proud of, and it was a very helpful thing during my administration as well. Let's see. For years, it bothered me that we had a group in the Women's Council, and the name of it was the 20 to 40-year-olds. Mm-hmm. So giving that group a name called the Ladies of Excellence, yes. I'm proud of that, so we don't have to call them the 20 to 40-year-olds anymore.
Amen. Amen.
I was proud to, being that I was I was the youngest person to be elected as president, I was proud to bring young people to the forefront by appointing them to serve in areas of leadership, like the IWC Youth Academy, who's a young person that I appointed to put over that. So I was proud of that, to see the young people not just attending, but actively working.
Working, yes, yes, yes. And you were mentoring them in the process. Yes, that was a great accomplishment. So what were some of the biggest challenges you experienced during your administration? Because with accomplishments also comes challenges also.
How long did you say the interview was going to be? All right. I think the obvious challenge was my sister, Mother Renee Ireland.
Yes.
The first year she was there with me, I called her 3 or 4 times a day, giving her ideas and getting her opinion about it. And the second year she transitioned and went home to be with the Lord.
Yes.
And this was, the IWC was our thing. It's something we did together since I was a little girl. She was more than my older sister, but she was my caretaker. She was like a mother to me. And wherever she went, she had to take me with her. So I grew up in a women's council, and I was excited about being president for years, because she was legally blind. I was her eyes. And being her eyes, I learned so much history of the Women's Council. It's something I know like the back of my hand. And not having her there, it was a big challenge. I think that was the biggest challenge, because I thought about it. I said, well, she was the only person to have worked with every IWC president.
Yes.
Except for me. You know, I'm like, did you have to go now, dear?
I know. She was definitely a mentor for me. And one who I'll never forget, one of the great women of the IWC. And like you, I didn't know her as long as you, but I learned so much from her. And again, as you said, the history. So that was a great asset. So I'm sure it was a great challenge also when she transitioned. So how would you like to be remembered today? How would you like to be remembered?
That in reference to challenges, my sister transitioning was the biggest challenge, but Mother Miriam Norwood was my mentor. And she transitioned as well during my administration, and her homegoing was during the Women's Council, and I wasn't able to attend. So I was at the Women's Council, but I was thinking about, I want to be at the homegoing to give honor to Mother Norwood. That was a huge challenge. Hurricane Sandy happened, I think that was 2013. And 2014, I had a severe car accident. But through all of those challenges, God prevailed. He gave me strength. He ministered to me, and he helped me to do what needed to be done with the Women's Council. So although it was very challenging, I give God praise, because he pulled me through. There's a song that says, he keeps pulling me through. Thank you for pulling me through. I can really relate to that song, because he carried me through it. So we give God praise.
Amen. Amen. And how would you like to be remembered today?
It's funny because, you know, I have a sense of humor. So, you know, it's going to come out in the interview. I thought I would be remembered for several things. And I found out that the young people remember me for my shoes. And I thought that was just hilarious. The shoes and the gloves. I thought that was hilarious.
What I
would like to be remembered as the president that brought forth spiritual meetings, that had a good evangelism report. I served as vice president of evangelism for 2 terms, you know, So I would like to be remembered that we had good evangelism reports. I'll never forget the woman in Miami that intended to walk into the ocean and keep going.
Yes.
And she came into the service and got saved, got baptized.
Yes.
You know, that's what I want to be remembered for, that we had a Holy Ghost good time, that we did praise the Lord, and that people were baptized and they were filled with the Holy Ghost. People got delivered and set free. That's what I want to be remembered for.
Amen. And you are remembered, because I remember that night vividly with that young lady being at the hotel and coming in. And oh, yeah. So this day.
It was awesome.
It was just awesome. You just had to be there to get what we're saying. You just had to be there. I tell you, and God was truly in that. So yes, my next question would be, you kind of answered it, but who was the person or persons who helped you the most during your administration?
Well, you know, I have to say the IWC icon, Mother Renee Ireland.
Absolutely.
She taught me everything that I know.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, when she would, before she transitioned, I was just harassing her on the phone and bouncing back and forth with ideas, and she would give me suggestions. Mother Miriam Norwood really took me under her wing, and she helped me out a lot spiritually. Just the talks that she had with me.
Yes.
Being the youngest person to be elected president, I was underestimated simply because of my age, and people didn't understand that I really have the history of the Women's Council embedded in me.
Yes, you do.
Because before I could have memories, I was at the Women's Council. Mm-hmm. So she kept encouraging me, and I knew that she had my back. We can't forget about Dr. Dorcas McCoy.
Okay.
Yeah. The thing that she made, you know, even if it was just her getting up to introduce me, when she got finished, I felt so great. Sometimes I'm like, who is she talking about?
I know exactly what you mean. I know exactly what you mean. That's wonderful.
But anything I needed, I can call Dorcas McCoy, and she was there for me. Mother Susie McCoy, as a former, invited me to Florida, and I had a wonderful time, and she was able to tell me some things that are not written in the book, and I really do appreciate her for that. Some things that no matter how you work in a woman's council, until you become president, you won't know, and you will always need the immediate past president to help you out. She wasn't my immediate past president, but she was there for me. Mother was the person that took me out the background. I was a background worker, and I was happy and content being in the background. And she is the person that said, I want you to be over the banner and awards committee. And I was like, so that's where I started from not working in the background. It was through her putting me over the banner and awards committee. But how many people can I name? Can I keep going? Okay, so what surprised me the most was one of the executive staff members. Mm-hmm. I thought she was quiet as a cucumber.
Mm-hmm.
And this woman is so spiritual and anointed and such an excellent singer, Mother Green.
Yes.
And we started calling Mother Green. Oh, she was awesome during administration. She was the sergeant of arms, kept everything in order. She became my friend. She was a good encourager. Would just give her songs and she would sing it to me. And that just blessed my soul. Now, I cannot leave out this one person. Mm-hmm. My daughter made the ultimate sacrifice when I became president.
Yes.
And I think if I had known she was going to do it, I would have said, no, don't do it. But she did it without me knowing. But she moved things in her life so that she could be 100% available for me. And yes, we became my right-hand person. So amen. I definitely don't want to leave her out. And Gloria Johnson, mm-hmm. I can call her up any time of night. Gloria mm-hmm. had her own staff, you know, Gloria Johnson. I'm going to go ahead and tell it. She did. And anytime I needed something, I could call her. Even when it came down to earning something, she got her staff together, mm-hmm. her crew, that's what I used to call them. And they uh-huh. stayed up one night just ironing the things that needed to be done for the Women's mm-hmm. Council. You remember those white covers I used to use on the chairs? Well, when they came to us, they were really wrinkled. We didn't have time to send them anywhere to get pressed out. And she got a group of people together and they stayed up half the night just ironing those covers so that we could have them for the podium. So she was a big help. And mm-hmm. I got to work with one of my best friend. Mm-hmm. And that was good too, because she was on staff and I could mm-hmm. talk to her about anything, including, you know, what was going on staff. And she's mm-hmm. very confidential, Lady Brenda Hindley.
Oh, God.
So I would say those are the people mm-hmm. that helped me the most during my administration. Amen. And if I forgot anybody, y'all just, you know, charge it to my head and not my heart, okay?
Yeah.
Love you, everybody.
Well, one thing, when you're a leader, you do surround yourself with people that are going to, that want to help you and be a blessing. So thank God that I was able to be a part of that. And certainly, again, I'm even where I am here today because of a lot of things that you taught me and Mother Renee Ireland taught me. So, I mean, I have a lot to be grateful for too. So this interview, being able to talk to you like this, really has been a blessing to me. And so as we're moving forward, what advice would you give to someone who's aspiring to be president?
Pray, seriously, I laughed, but hey, you're aspiring to be president, pray.
Amen.
Serve on a local and the state level and in every area of the international level as possible.
Mm-hmm.
You would do yourself an injustice to be a local president, and then say, now I'm going to run for president. There's so much to learn about the Women's Council, and the president has to be well-rounded. She has to understand the Department of Evangelism, Home Mission, Global Mission. There's so much that is that you have to know being the president. I would say to start working on the international level, get on every committee that you can get on. Mm-hmm. I would recommend serving a couple of terms as vice president. Don't skip the vice presidency and say, I want to be president. Mm-hmm. I believe a good leader is a good follower.
Amen.
And then I would say, pray again to ensure that it's the will of God, because you don't want to do it out of your will. There's nothing glamorous about being the president of the Women's Council. I loved every minute of it, but you're going to lose some hours of sleep. And if you are a married woman, then you also need to check with your husband, because you're going to lose some sleep. You're going to be very much preoccupied, and not every man is willing to make that sacrifice. I thank God for my husband, because he was with me every step of the way. So that's something to consider as well, even though the president can be single. Amen.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. So my next question would be, and that's good advice for anyone aspiring, what advice would you give to someone, what advice would you give to the next president? The IWC has an election that's going to be coming up. What advice would you give to those, to the next president who wins that election?
Well, if I can be transparent a little bit.
Absolutely.
One of the things I've noticed throughout the years is that when we get a new president, we kind of throw the baby out with the water. and mm-hmm. it has disturbed me greatly for years. So mm-hmm. what I would say to the next president, keep the original God-given vision of the IWC and mm-hmm. add thou to it.
Amen. Good advice. Good advice. Good advice. Lady Christian, I tell you, this has been such a wonderful experience to sit and talk with you. I thank you so much for sharing with us on this evening. And as we are celebrating, March is Women's Month, and that's what we're doing. We honor you. We honor all the past presidents, the women of God, but we honor you and every one of your contributions to the IWC, to Cool JC, to the ministry of this wonderful Savior, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and to the women of God. We thank God for you. We thank God for you giving us this time in your interview. And all I can say is God bless you. I love you. And I'm praying for you. Peace be unto you and to everyone who was watching. I say love, prayer, multiple blessings, and peace to you. God bless you. Until next time, stay safe in Jesus' name.
Amen. God bless you. God bless you.